Yo! Hi, Pastor James here. I hope you had a wonderful week. It is so hot and humid in Washington, D.C. area. But it is okay. We are still alive, and isn't that good news? How are you? Are you getting far away from the bone, as I am? I gained a few pounds. Or are you getting close to the bone now? You must be drop dead gorgeous. In fact, I'm really hooked on one of the CCM songs. I can't even stop shaking my body as I listen to this song. I was so excited. I had to move my butt, what mama gave to me. Have you heard the Lion of Judah? Word and music by Sonny Tranca. This song was actually sung by a young group. I was really into these songs. Let's listen to a little bit. Yes, we have to keep exercise, and both physically and spiritually. Please make sure you maintain your beauty and you drop the gorgeous beauty. Actually, during last week, and I was really touched by one stage person action. His name is Mr. O'Neill Sadler. He's a Georgia state trooper. As we all know, Black Lives Matter protests are still on everywhere. This Georgia State Trooper O'Neill Sadler was allegedly asked to kneel during a demonstration in Hartwell, but he didn't kneel down. Instead, he said,
"I mean, respect. I wouldn't have took. I'm supposed to be out of town this weekend with my wife. I took off today, this weekend, but I'm out here to make sure y'all safe. Okay. Don't go there with respect, okay?
Okay, thank you.
I have much respect, but I only kneel for one person,
and that's God.
God, okay.
Thank you, Pastor. But
what a brave police officer. What a wonderful Christian police officer. Can you do that? Without any negotiating with the world, can you say to the people, or can you shout out to the world that I kneel for only God? I hope we all can. I want to take a look at Samuel. As we all know, the prophet Samuel was a great servant of God. As a prophet, as a priest, as a judge, God used him as a great leader in that period. Why? How? That's a good question, right? Because he has been serving God with fear and all truthful heart. Let's read 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 11 and 18. Then Elkanah went home to Ramah, but the boy ministered before the Lord under Eli the priest. But Samuel was ministering before the Lord, a boy wearing a linen ephod. Think about his circumstance, his situation. He was growing up, well, not good at all. His parents left the baby at the temple as they promised to God, because his mother pledged to God that she would give a baby to God if she has one. And she kept the promise. What a wonderful woman, just like your mom and my mom. And he had to grow up with two wicked sons of priest Eli. If you look at chapter 2 and verse 12 through 17, you can see they robbed the people. They are selfish. They have fallen from God. And even Bible indicated they are sinners who contempt the offering to God. I see in these Bible verses, not every PKs are good. I hope you are good PKs, just like Samuel. I hope you are not one of them. His personal environment was not great. And also, his country was not great either. At time, Israel was corrupted and they worshipped to idols. So the whole country and his personal environment was really hard to grow as a wonderful person. However, Samuel became one of God's servants. Why? Because he served God all the time. Here, the word serving means not only worship, but also serving others. Just think about how to serve God. You can pray. You can read the Bible. You can worship. You can praise. Yeah, that's how we worship. But at the same time, I want you to know that you can serve others with God's love. That is what true serving means. You know what? During this pandemic time, I really appreciate our church families. Our church members made masks for our neighbors and elderly and made meals for the senior adult and helped one another. Samuel was the one served God in the time of darkness of Israel. I hope you become 21st century Samuel. Serve God as do something for your neighbors, for your parents, or for your grandparents, or for your brothers and sisters. Shine Jesus. Especially those who are graduating from high school and colleges, I want you to have braveness and courage to serve God. Do something as a Christian. Shout out to the world. I only kneel for God. I only live for God. Jesus is the only one we worship. I am sure God will use you as a great leader. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you for giving us loving family, loving parents, and loving brothers and sisters. Even though we go through this pandemic, Father, we are still here in this planet. I am sure you have a reason to give us life. Let us not give up. Let us not negotiate with the world wicked things. Let us not be tempted by any evil things. Let us continuously glorify your name only. Let us continuously praise your name only. Father, we want to have the courage, the braveness to shout out to the world, I only kneel for God. I'm asking your abundant blessing, all those medical staffs who are working so hard to taking care of patients. And also I'm praying for our political leaders. I hope they surrender you as a Lord. They can be led by your spirit. Father, thank you for your blessing, your salvation through Jesus Christ. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.